the Islamic world, many Muslims are being transformed by dreams and visions. Here's the powerful story of just one testimony out of these thousands of new believers.
I began my journey about 14 years old, and it was kind of a surprise to me, honestly, because I thought the more I give myself over to the Islamic ways and the prayers and doing the best I could, I thought it would change my life, and it just simply didn't. Growing up, you never dared to criticize Islam. You never ever ask about Muhammad, the Prophet of Islam, or Allah, the God of the Quran. 70% of the Arabic population in the Middle East is under the age of 30. This new generation, kind of what worked for our parents, isn't going to work for us. That's why we have Facebook, we have Twitter, we have the internet, we have computers, we have satellite television. All of this stuff has given us, the Arab Middle East, you know, population, courage to actually think outside the box.
Muslims in Jerusalem, what they
think. Villages. I was ignorant, you know, I was young, but I was sincere in my search for God. My reasoning was if I could win them over to Islam, then maybe Islam would be a little bit more appealing.
Extreme,
and that began about a year and a half journey of searching what is truth, and I ended up giving my life over to the Lord Jesus at the end. What I looked for all those years was love, and I found love. I looked for peace, and I found peace. All the things that you couldn't buy and that Islam couldn't give me, that's what I found in Jesus. So my life changed radically. I call it Christianity by choice, not something a part of the culture. I choose today to live for Jesus. For about 2.5 years, I was an underground believer. I thought I was the only ex-Muslim in the world, and I know that sounds ridiculous, but it's the truth. At that age, I had never heard of anyone leaving Islam and coming. You don't plan on leaving Islam. No real Muslim from a real Islamic culture, a Middle Eastern culture, would ever consider leaving Islam because they know what happens. Well, if we were in a completely perfect Islamic society, it's Islamic Sharia law that our death is completely legal. I hear people say all the time that, oh, Islam is a peaceful religion, but it kind of is insulting to me.
He says when Muslim leaders want to unite the masses.
I'm from the culture, I've read the verses, I know what's in there. And because of this political correctness there, people just want to look the other way. Well, we've done that for so long. Now what's happening is stuff like terrorism.
The verge of a third Palestinian intifada, a word that means uprising, based from 2000 to 2004.
There is terrorist characteristics. At the core root of Islam is to propagate Islam around the world. And that's what is, I feel like that's what they're trying to do
here in the halls of Congress and with our leadership.
Clute's view on defeating radical Islam.
People that we try to talk to and tell are trying to ignore us, like thinking, oh, well, you're being radical. No, I'm not being radical. This is Quranic verses telling you to kill me. What are you going to do with that? I remember I was invited to a cell group. I look at the guy to my left, I said to him, how did you become a Christian? He said, oh, Jesus came to me in a vision. I looked to the girl to my right, and I said, how did you come to know the Lord? She said, most of us in this room have had dreams or visions of Jesus. There's a growing population of young people who are seeing the dreams and visions and knowing the gospel. Ways to help is to pray. Pray for the Middle East, pray for the believers. Second is to support ministries that are making an impact. Pray, see who God would have you to support, and do it.